I'm Jilly Dreadful, and I am a sci-fi, fantasy, and horror writer. I have a PhD in creative writing and literature from the University of Southern California, and I did my dissertation on cyborgs, zombies, vampires, magical girls, and made a haunted dollhouse that was animated and you conjured my writing as ghosts. And so yeah, I'm a big nerd. I'm a member of SIFWA, which is the Science Fiction and Fantasy Writers Association, which is the same association that Ray Bradbury joined. And so it was always my goal to join SIFWA. And my first book of short stories, called Cosmobiological, is coming out later this year. So, I'm really excited about this palette. I am a plebe. I'm a plebeian. I have a PhD, so I like to remind myself to use it every once in a while with words like plebeian. And so I bought this with my own money, and I'm going to give you the experience of a normal person ordering this palette. The ordering experience for the pre-order on January 19th was really smooth. It didn't sell out, like, you know, in 30 seconds. There weren't any glitches on the site. It was really easy. I did order it on January 19th. It arrived yesterday, which was February 16th. I am speeding through this video, trying to get it up in time for anyone who wants to, like, get extra information before the restock goes live tonight. Anyway, so let's get into the palette. All of the good things that people are saying are true. I have now used, in the last 2 days, I've done 3 different eye looks with it, and it is... I'm a writer, and I don't have words. That doesn't happen often. All of the mattes are really surprisingly pigmented, even the lime green. This lime green, you know, is maybe very reminiscent to the Juvia's Place Tribe palette, but that Tribe palette lime green color is kind of sheer and has to be built up. And this gravity color is vibrant and opaque, and it's a relatively, you know, like, brighter color, which sometimes can come out a little bit more sheer or watercolor-esque on the eye, and it doesn't do that. So the mattes are spectacular, and they blend into each other and make a really beautiful gradient with, like, barely any work. They also blend out really nicely, so that it doesn't feel like you're getting patchy, but you're just getting sort of this really cool blown out, like, soft fade. The shimmers. And I know the chef's kiss is a little overdone in the makeup community on YouTube, but seriously, it's that good. If you're like me and you've hesitated on buying Kaleidos shadows because they're kind of expensive, this is a really good substitute or alternative to buying really expensive single shadows, because you're getting 6 sparkly, super sparkly shades, and they all have a very clear duochrome, and 2 of them claim to be multichromes, and maybe that's the only thing that I could have a nitpicky thing to say, a nitpicky criticism to say about the palette, is that the multichromes, they don't really come across as multichromes to me, but I might just be a plebe and can't seem to get the color shift to show me more than 2. One of the multichromes is Astro, and I couldn't get the teal blue purple shift. I couldn't really get a purple, and if I could get, like, some of the purple, I couldn't get the teal at the same time, but as a duochrome it works. I'm going to be including swatch comparisons to other palettes in my collection, so in case you can't buy it, you can at least, you know, look in your archive of palettes and maybe see if there's something, so it'll sort of tide you over. And do you see how much of a nerd I am? I have unicorn
from Blade Runner.
All right. Anyway, Club Nebula swatches. Kaleidos Futurism 2 Astro Pink Palette. But yeah, not similar at all. I feel like these two, the Astro and this blue, they are very similar. Alright, Beach Pistachio Palette. Okay, so Sweet Life. Okay, Sweet Life in the definitely not like Firefly. Do Dessert. Ooh, okay. This is Dessert and that's Firefly. And they are very similar. This one, let's try it out. Ooh! Okay. It's Queen of Blades and Cone or Cup. Do Nutty. Yeah, it's just a very different tone of lime green. Alright, so this is BH from the pistachio palette. So it's this, this, and this. I just made this one bigger so you could see it like directly next to Firefly. BH Cosmetics Avocado Toast. Avocado. Avo Toast. Yep, much different lime green. The BH Blueberry Muffin. Okay, so Delish. Really nothing like 7 of 9. Ooh, tempting. I'll do Astro. Do Cravings. And You're My Only Hope. Hot Fresh. Sugared. Decadent. Whoa. All right, that was unexpected. All right, so Decadent does look like Cylon. Do Treat. And that's me. Yummy. Okay, so for the BH Cosmetics Blueberry Muffin, the blues are nothing similar, and the shimmers, you got a couple that are a little bit of a contender. Cravings is similar to Celestial. It'll give you, it's like a drugstore alternative to this palette. Treat is nothing like Rockhopper. However, Tempting is like a good alternative for Astro, but Decadent and Cylon, like those are very similar. Wow. But Yummy, they're nothing. Like they're not similar at all. They're just Sugar Pill Capsule 1, the pink palette. Are not close. I mean, this blue is nowhere near Void. And so this blue is a little bit closer to 7 of 9, but it's not at all. But Cloud 9 is like a shimmery version of 7 of 9. Okay, well, we got Radiate. Okay, those are very, very similar. The only difference is that Gravity has the very slightest sheen to it. Okay, and then Ember. Dream State. I'll put it next to You're My Only Hope. Those are very different. The purples are not going to be anywhere. Okay, and that's the purple from the sugar pill too. Here's Supernova. Let's put it down here with Nova. It has less of a transparent base. And it's way more violet than blue. Sugar pill capsule palette. Volume 2, the orange palette, green, obviously it's a shimmer, but very similar tone. The blue, this is very different than Astro. Moonshine. The Nomad Cosmetics Harajuku palette. Let's do Otaku. Supernova. Moshi Moshi. Okay, so Moshi Moshi and Firefly are similar to Kawaii and now it's Forever. That's not, yeah, this is not the same. All right, Visual K. Wow, on camera, at least in my viewfinder, they look Rock Copper and Visual K look very, like, they look almost exactly the same, but in person, this has definitely more of a purple lean to it, and this is more of a brownish taupe. Koroinichi? Oh yeah, not, I mean, nope. Alright, so the Harajuku palette, there's not a lot of similarities, but some of the special shades you might be able to get a similar vibe from if you already have it. Nabla Secret palette. Alright, so Play Hard. Addiction. Fantasize. Let's do that for Astro. Yeah, those are so different. Contigo. That Big Experience. This is a shimmer, so yeah, it's not even a similar tone. This Red Giant to Rosemary. Yeah. Addiction is a similar vibe to Queen of Blades, but nothing else is that similar. The Juvia's Place Tribe palette. A Sigh. Tootsie. Yeah, like maybe together they can make that shade, but they're both pretty different. Sun. Yeah, that's not similar to Queen of Blades. And since I'm here, yeah, not similar at all. By Beauty Bay Book of Magic palette. Bewitched. Get Cursed. Voodoo. Let's do Spell. Your Astro. Then Potion. Your Astro. Do Moonlight. Air Supernova. I don't know, let's just do Jinx. Can we get close? No. Alright, and Crystal. Alright. It
it's a little bit of a similar vibe, but on to the next. Ace Beauté Flare Palette. Forest Pine. Queen of Blades. Alright, we've got Sherbet. Sherbet is way more neon yellowish than Gravity, but like on camera they look the same, so probably on your eyes might be function the same. Acorn. Let's do Rockhopper. Atlantis. Yeah. No. Bayberry. Yeah, no. Biscotti. And You're My Only Hope. Nope. Alright, and Pumpkin. For Samus. Whoa, no, not the same. Mirage. For Red Giant, Mirage is a shimmer shade. But we're closer in tone. Mulberry. For Naru. You know, I think the Flare palette gives you a little bit of a similar vibe, but it's really missing those special shades. Alright, ColourPop, just my look. Maybe Act Natural? No. Mary Jane, this is a shimmer. That's a hard pass. Alright, Blue Moon. We clued in. Yeah, and that's not similar at all. Okay, Lumi. Moving on. I like you a lot. Okay. You're My Only Hope. No. Imagine that. Oop. Oh yeah, nope. Alright, so ColourPop was a bust. The next water palette. Yeah, nope. Yeah. Yeah, no, this is not good. Not similar enough. Alright, so to recap, in case you can't get your hands on Club Nebula or you can't afford it, or you're on a no-buy, whatever, here are some alternative palettes that will give you similar vibes. But they're not dupes by any stretch of the imagination. So Sugar Pill, Pink Capsule Volume 1, BH Cosmetics Pistachio Palette, Firefly for dessert. Or dessert is a similar to Firefly, and Ace Beauté Flare palette. my final conclusion, this is a super unique palette. Hi. I have a PhD for observing obviousness. Okay, so that about wraps it up for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If it was helpful, or if you did enjoy it at any time, I'd appreciate it if you hit the thumbs up button, hit subscribe, and join my YouTube channel. That would be cool. If you made it this far, tell me what your favorite sci-fi thing is. Like, do you have a favorite sci-fi movie, novel, video game, all of the above? Let me know. I'm always interested to find new sci-fi things, or also to just, you know, nerd out with you in the comments. All right, I will see you next time. Bye.